they noted that when the Iranians were saying about the technical of the tanker, they said the British need to understand this isn't 1953, which I thought was a very significant thing for them to say. But of course it goes on much earlier than that, to do with the various imperialists wanting to get control of the oil. Winston Churchill, Boris Johnson's hero, before the First World War wanted to move from coal-fired ships to oil-fired ships, and therefore you find the establishment of the Anglo-American Oil Company and those kind of things. So we've got a history here, and nobody is more aware of that history than the Iranian people themselves, and they're aware not just of that history, but of the constant opposition to the Iranian Revolution and what followed the Iranian Revolution, their intervention on the side of Iraq during the Iran-Iraq War, the shooting down of the civilian airliner towards the end of that war. So all of this is history that people don't forget and aren't ignorant about, as maybe many people in this country might not know about it. So all of that is important, I think, in looking at all these things. And then, of course, we come on to the question of Boris Johnson here in Downing Street and Trump in the White House. And this is it's absolutely clear that Johnson would like to follow Trump in all of these adventures, not simply to do with trade deals and to do with the main flows of the United States, but because this fits in with his view of the whole role of Britain in the world. And of course, Johnson and the people who think like him have got a fantastic problem here. They want to hark back to the glory days of the British Empire and all this kind of thing. But actually, one of the consequences of recent events, including the Brexit vote and all the things that happened, is that actually it represents a realistic cutting down to size of what Britain actually means in the world. And it's something that they find incredibly hard to deal with. They don't want to deal with it. They don't want to lose their seat on the Security Council. They don't want to give up their nuclear weapons. They don't want to do any of these things. But this is the direction in which things are moving. That Britain is a medium-sized power which cannot play the role that it did 50 or 100 or 100 years ago. And this is something which they will do all that they can to try to counter that. And one of the ways that you counter that is by banging the drum for war. And that, it seems to me, is one of the dangers that we have to have. So I just want to, I guess I've had my... Shelley keeps looking at me, so I guess I've had my 10 minutes. But just to conclude by saying this, although, as I say, the situation kind of changes week by week in terms of the immediate issues that are going on in Iran, this is a long-term issue. It is not going to disappear. It's not going to go away in 3 months or 6 months or a year. It is what the imperialists want to do. There is a conflict in the Middle East which is absolutely fundamental. And it will be a war, when you talk about a war, it will be a war which is not just about Iran, it will be about Lebanon, it will be about Israel and Palestine, it will be about Syria and Iraq. It will take in all of those countries in the region and more, and it will be something which will be catastrophic for the people of that region, and of course for us, because although, again, we're not talking probably about direct war involving millions of British people or hundreds of thousands of British people, it is an absolute blot on what is supposed to be a civilized society that we conduct these wars in these ways and that we think we have a right to tell people how to run their governments and how to use their resources. So this is a big conflict. I think we have to all prepare ourselves in the way that we talked about earlier today in terms of the meetings. We've got a pamphlet coming out in a couple of weeks about Iran. We've got all sorts of different things. We want people to build as big a campaign as possible saying don't attack Iran, don't